Let us take the next question. Here it is given, design the diameter of solid circular shaft to transmit 50 kilowatts power at 100 rpm, full stop. Maximum torque is likely to exceed mean torque by 25%. Then maximum permissible shear stress is 60 megapascal. Also calculate angle of twist for a length of 2 meter. Take capital G as 80 GPa. Now this is the question which we have in front of us. Whatever is given here, I will write that in the form of data first. So let us start with this question. Here it is given that we have to design the diameter of solid circular shaft. So I'll write capital D as the diameter of solid circular shaft. To transmit 50 kilowatts power, power is given. So it is 50 into 10 raised to 3 watts at 100 rpm. Maximum torque is likely to exceed mean torque by 25%. So this relation is maximum torque is likely to exceed. So it is 1.25 times of mean torque. Since they have given that it is 25% more, so it is 1.25 times of mean torque. If in the question they would have mentioned that it is 30% more, so this would have been 1.3 into T mean. Next, maximum permissible shear stress is 60 FS value. Here they are saying the first part is we have to calculate the diameter, and also they are saying to calculate the angle of twist. So the next thing which we have to calculate is theta for a length of 2 meter. Capital L is 2 meter. So I have to convert it into mm. Take capital G, modulus of rigidity, as 80 GPa. This I will convert it. It becomes 80 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per millimeter square. So this is the question which we have. Now let us try to find the solution for this. As power is given, I will start from the equation. I'll say that solution, since power transmitted by a solid shaft is given by power is equal to 2 pi nt upon 60 . Here I'll draw the cross section. Of solid circular shaft. Therefore, power is given in the question as 50 into 10 raised to 3 watts. RPM is 100. Therefore, T will be equal to 50 10 raised to 3 into 60 divided by 2 pi into 100. So from this I will be getting the torque value as 4.77 into 10 raised to 3 Newton meter. Now this torque which I am getting from the power formula, that is nothing but mean torque. So I'll say that therefore T mean is equal to 4.77 into 10 raised to 3 Newton meter. Now they have given us a relation that since T max is 1.25 times of T mean, that is 25% more. So therefore I will say that T max is equal to 1.5 times of T mean. The value is 4.77 into 10 raised to 3. Therefore, the T max value, it comes out to be 5.97 into 10 raised to 3 Newton meter, which I will convert it to Newton mm. That is 5.97 into 10 raised to 6 Newton millimeter. Now this is the value of torque which I will use in the problem. As we see in this case, the first question is to calculate the diameter and they have given shear stress. So I will use the strength criteria. By strength criteria, the formula is T by J is equal to Fs by R. Therefore, T it is 5.97 into 10 raised to 6. J for solid shaft it is pi by 32 d raised to 4. Fs is given in the question as 60 Newton per mm square. R is d by 2. Now here I can cancel one diameter from this side and one from the other side. This is 2 and this becomes 16. So I'll keep d cube on one side, that is therefore d cube will be equal to 5.97 into 10 raised to 6 divided by pi by 16 into 60. So if I calculate here, I would be getting my answer of diameter as it comes out to be 79.72 millimeter. This is my first answer. Now as we look into this question, they are even telling us to calculate the value of theta. So if theta is asked, I have to use the rigidity criteria. I'll say that since by rigidity criteria, T by J is equal to G theta by L. T value that was 5.97 into 10 raised to 6. The value of J, it was pi by 32 d raised to 4. G, that is modulus of rigidity, it is 80 into 10 raised to 3. Theta is what we have to calculate, and the length of the shaft given here, it is 2000. So here, as we see, theta has been asked. This diameter we have calculated just now. So I'll keep theta on one side and shift all the terms on the other side. So here I have theta is equal to 5.97 into 10 raised to 6. This 2000 would be multiplied in the numerator, divided by pi by 32. Diameter which we have got just now, that is 79.72 raised to the power 4. Then this would be multiplied by 80 into 10 raised to 3. So from this, if I calculate, theta value comes out to be 0.0376 radians, and this is my second answer. So here I have solved this question, that is we have calculated the diameter of shaft and also the angle of twist. With this we complete the problem.